Now we know how to make a DateTime object, we should learn how to do things with them. One of the first things we might like to do is compare dates. Date comparisons are made very easy in PHP. Many older tutorials will suggest you have to turn all dates into Unix timestamps before you compare the number of seconds, but DateTime objects can be compared directly. Try and steer clear of the old date and str to time functions, and definitely avoid adding and subtracting specific numbers of seconds to change dates due to time zone complications. Let's take a look at time zones in the next video. Let's open the index.php file in our workspace now, and have a look at another handy feature of DateTime that's often underutilized. On lines 3 and 4, we are creating two new DateTime objects, both of which contain a date in a supported format. On line 3 is an object named Devon, and on line 4 contains an object called Spike. These DateTime objects represent the birthdays of famous WWE wrestlers Devon Dudley and Spike Dudley. Below that, on line 8, is an if statement. This if statement is comparing which is lesser out of the two objects. At first, it might seem odd to compare two objects directly, but when this is used, the internal values of the date, regardless of the format they were created with, will be compared to see which is the lesser of the two. Think about it. If somebody is born in 1900, then that is a smaller number than 2000, and somebody born in 1900 is certainly older than someone born in 2000. When we run this, we should expect to see the paragraph Spike is older than Devon output, as Spike was born in 1970, almost 2 years before Devon. Great, our if statement worked, and we know who is older. Comparisons are useful, but we can also look at the actual difference between the two dates. This will let us see what the age gap really is. So we go back to our workspace here, uncomment these lines, and refresh that. There we have it. There is 1 year, 11 months, and 19 days between Spike and Devon. But how do we do that? On line 16, we are creating an object and storing it in a variable called diff. This object is an instance of date time interval, and that means we can call methods on it. One method we will call is the format method. This is a little different to the DateTime format method, but works in much the same way. We can pass it a string and use certain characters preceded by a percentage sign to denote actual values that represent a portion of the difference. For example, we have a %y, which will show the number of years, a %m, which shows the number of months, and %d, which, you guessed it, shows the number of days. That's a good introduction to DateTime and comparisons. So now we're going to move on to time zones.